All right, now for this two cherries chisel. This is going to be more just eyeball putting it in the jig because there are no, these are not parallel to one another, so it's going to be very difficult to try to determine squareness, and the edge is not that wide enough to take a accurate measurement. So I'm just going to put it in there and get it in as close as I can, and however that edge works out to be, that's going to be fine. If it's a little off, it'll be more like a skew chisel, but it's going to be just perfect. So again, this is just this one had the angle was just fine. The angle was just fine on this one. So of all the chisels and stuff that I'm sharpening, this one had never been put on the belt sander or on the Makita. So this one's going to go just from the last time that I sharpened it on these stones and get rehoned. So let's get it in the jig and get started. Centered. And again, I'm going to check using my stick to be well away from that bevel interfering with the plastic on the back. I can actually come back just a little bit so I don't have too much knife sticking out. Check it again. That looks good. Let's see, can you see I got that? See that distance right in there? So that's sitting flat on the facet, and I got plenty of room away from the plastic. So let me get a good crank down on that. Loosen this up from the last time. Okay, so I'm gonna put this down here. I've got the back flapping. I'm gonna put my thumb on it. That looks good. I'm gonna try that right off the bat. Extra coarse. Let me take a couple licks and see where I am. I'm a little bit back here on the heel, but I think it's going to be just fine. It looks, this is so flat from being honed before that it should straighten out really quickly here. I'm almost up to the front here. Almost. That's one, that's already a clean, beautiful facet all the way across the front now, extra coarse. I feel a slight burr on the back. Let me hit it a little bit more. There it is. So I'm gonna come over here to fine. Fine is always left over here in the deburring position unless I need it over here, and then I'll switch them back and forth between the two. So you can really get a feel for how important it is to have this free space here. I can't stress how important that is enough. You can leave your knife in the jig and I mean, look how high a block you'd have to have the stone set up if you were doing this in the middle of a table. To do it without interference off this handle. Okay, I can really feel that piece of wire there. Yeah, I wish I had some kind of magnifying ability to show you that piece of wire. Maybe sometime later I'll have some better photographic skills to show that. Now I've got coarse. Burrs there. So that's all I needed to do on course. So now let me knock this wire off the back, knock this burr off. See, this knife goes to show you when you're already sharp and the facet is already flat, it takes a lot less time than coming in with my coarsely ground edges. It took a little bit longer, like on the rat chisel. Okay, so now I have my fine. Now I'm gonna switch between the fine in between these two locations. So let me, and again, the higher grit I go, the more sideways and circular. Putting a lot of pressure back here on the heel. And not as much up on the front. Virtually impossible to rock this blade forward and round my edge off using this style of jig that holds it at a precise angle but really distributes the pressure. There's my burr. Extra fine. All right, that one's done. Let's see if we can get a look at it here in the light. It's sharp. We'll test it. We're gonna test all these. And again, back this off a little bit so you can hold that metal up out of the way. Carefully take your knife out so you don't damage your bright, fresh edge. And there you go.